She spent over 30 years as a news anchor, making her one of the country's most recognizable and trusted broadcasters.
And we're delighted to have her back on the 6 o'clock show again. Anne Doyle.
The glamour and the glitz. You were that serious woman you showed earlier. Really.
Don't know who that was.
Particularly the one with the black hair. Not anybody I ever met.
Does that hair bring you back the old dark hair?
Mercifully, I'm at a stage where I've forgotten.
It's gone.
Listen, it's 8 years since you did your last broadcast. Well, nearly 8 years since you did your last broadcast. Christmas Day, 2011. Are you enjoying retirement? Is it treating you well?
Extremely well, I'd have to say. It simply means that I have more time to do what I dedicated my life to anyway, which is to get up to as much mischief as possible, but not to live it out on screen. In other words, not to get caught.
Or on your phone. No, you don't do that either. No.
Well, I could be educated on this program.
Okay, well, you never know by the end of it. You just don't know. But of course, like you said, you've timed your hands to do other things and other projects. Hurling is the next one. Because you are a proud Wrexham woman, so we assume you're a hurling fan.
I'm a huge hurling fan. I have been to the 96 All-Ireland, probably referencing the winning ones, 68. And though a small child, I was in the square in Ferns when the 56 team came home. See, bald head together with the blue. I was there, of course, when we lost in the semi-final. And it actually broke my heart. It took me 24 hours to recover.
Yeah, well, that's championship, isn't it? That's, it's enjoyable, it's in your blood, and yeah. Anyway, because of your knowledge of hurling, you're now involved in a very special project and a very special game, because you're going to be working the line.
I'm trying to ease off on the knowledge. I'm hoping that some likely youngster will run up and down with better eyesight than me and I can just wave the flag. But it's a fabulous event. This year, it's eighth year. Two teams, one J.B. Russell's Best and Jim Bulger's Stars.
Yeah.
And it has thus far raised, I think it's about in the regions of 885,000. And there's the most fantastic lineup. I mean, the umpires, the lineswomen, for God's sake.
The lineswomen.
Women. Miriam is there. Sheila Shoiga is there. Katie Walsh is there. Misha is there. But the umpires are really fabulous. Philip Mullins, you know, Rich Ritchie.
People are just going to be fouling so that you get to call them out. Like, I'm convinced of this.
Well, I inquired an acquaintance of mine who really is genuinely very knowledgeable about hurling. That's you, Dermot Kavanagh. And I said to him, look, you know, people take this very seriously when the chips are down. And, you know, because Jim Bulger has won three times, Davy twice, and two draws. So this could be very important
now.
And he said to me, doesn't matter, Jamman, you've got the flag. What are they going to do?
Nothing. Oh, you've got the flag.
You've got the power to have somebody sent off.
Well, you're...
You just notify the referee and go...
That's it.
I hope I don't entirely lose the run of myself. It's always quite likely, really.
There'll be a t-shirt the day after the match. I was sent off by Anne Doyle. I can see it. Because
what I'm worried about is a t-shirt that says Anne Doyle was sent off.
That's not going to happen.
That's more likely.
No, because I couldn't fail but to notice you recently at the 30th birthday.